Hello, everyone, and welcome to the third episode of From Zero to Hero. So, this episode, as well as episodes from now on, are mostly going to be me showing you like the cooler dungeon duos that I've done, along with maybe some smaller updates and stuff along the road. But people have really been asking me about showing my gear. Damn, why did I stutter so much? People have been asking me to show off my gear a little bit more, so people like can know what I'm using from level to level. So I'm going to quickly run you through what I've used up to now, and then what I'm using now, and sort of what I'm planning to use going forward, but not for the whole game. Just bear with me, please. So I started off with the Peewee set, obviously. Then I upgraded to like some sponge set or whatever, just some shitty sets. Then I went with a Scarleaf Blop set, which you can see here on my panda, a Blop with Scarleaf set and boots that give MP, and the weapon there gives range, the shield gives range, and I bought a mount that's 300 vitality, 100 chance, and Scarleaf hat, and then a cape that gives MP. I think I already said that. Now, everything that I have on my characters, I've earned through my characters. Like, the kamas that I'm making is only through my characters. Like, I'm just doing my dungeon achievements, selling my resources calmly, you know, just putting them in market. They sell pretty well, and I'm doing full achievements every time, so I get like 100 of each dungeon boss resource, so they sell pretty well. And on top of that, I'm doing a little bit of crushing on my rogue on the side just to make some extra cash. And so I got this gear going for me here, which is cool. And then I upgraded from that into the following set, which is here. So I got the Kara hat. I got this amulet, this ring, belt, Gelano and stuff, and I got this instead of a deluge, though I'm still using the mount. I didn't want the deluge, I changed my mind, decided to keep it, and I got this observator, which gives me 2 range, so it leaves me with 9 AP, 6 MP, and 6 range. But this is assuming that I have an MPX on my Gelano, which right now I don't. I have it as a vitality overmage. So instead, I don't have 6 MP, I have 5, and I have a little bit more vitality, though. And all my stuff is vitality overmage. So I got this, which is cool. And on my rogue, I went for this set. And the reason I went for this set is because of fire damage. So you see the set itself gives 29 fire damage. Now, it's not that easy to come by fire damage at low level, but this is the best stuff that I found for it. So this Vulcanian set, the hat gives 6 fire damage. This doesn't give any fire damage, but this one does. And then the backpack does, and the boots do, and the set bonus gives some fire damage. So in total, I got 29, which is cool. And I got this bow, which is really nice because it's 4 AP and it hits up to 8 range. Now, my rogue spells as an intelligence rogue right now are only Extraction, Pulsar, and my bomb, right? Now, Pulsar hits up to 6 range, which is decent range, but if I use any MP, then it doesn't hit as much, so it hits pretty bad. And Extraction's only up to 3 range, which is terrible. So this bow, combined with weapon skill, because even at level like 1, weapon skill gives you 300 power, which is crazy, but only like 300 power for weapons, right? So I can hit pretty hard with this up to 8 range, and sometimes it crits. I'll do like minus 250, almost 300. And I just got some random shitty shield here, blah blah. And now the set that I'm going to be going for on my rogue is this. So I already have this mount, by the way. I don't know what I have here. By the way, the peewees that I have, you might think, oh my god, they're so expensive in market, but since I did the Silver Dofus questline, you can actually get them, just exchange them for 500 peewee feathers of the respective peewee's colors. So if I wanted the red one, right, I just go with the red one, go buy 500 red peewee feathers. I did that. I got the blue one that I was using in my panda for a bit, and then I upgraded to what you see here, like this, the mount. I bought some minor survivors as well. I don't think I mentioned that. And honestly, I fucking love this team. Like, everything's going super, super well, super smooth. And I'm going to be going with this set just to increase my AP a little bit, because right now I'm chilling at 7, which is not ideal. And I got this going, which is nice. I'm going to buy a Gelano. I got this shield, which gives me range. And this AP, whatever you can see here, King Staff, this is really cool, 70 intelligence. And other than that, I think I've done basically everything to show you. So the set bonuses on this is going to be this. And then I'll keep you updated in the future for other sets that I'm going to be going for. I have so many plans for my team, and I can't wait to keep updating you guys. I'm really, really enjoying this. I think I'm enjoying Dofus on this team more than I've enjoyed Dofus in a very long time. So I hope you guys bear with me. This is just going to be really fun. So just I hope you guys enjoyed the dungeon duo. I'm going to be commenting over it for a bit. And yeah, enjoy the fight. Bye. All right, here we go. We are first the Great Correlator. So this is the last dungeon that I have to do from my level 1 to 51s. So I came here to Automai to finish it because I left this one for last because I thought it would be the coolest one. And the reason it's the coolest is because the achievements that I have to do are Impertinence and Blitzkrieg. So Impertinence is where I have to finish every turn next to one of the enemies. And Blitzkrieg is if I hit one of the mobs, then I have to kill it before it's before the start of its next turn. You guys, I assume you know this, but just in case, I just want to put that out there. So if I hit a mob, I have to finish it before its turn, and I have to finish all my turns right next to the mob. And the reason it's interesting is because the boss of this dungeon room has 2,000 HP. So 2,000 HP, that's not negligible, right? 2,000 HP, especially since considering I'm level 60. It's not that easy, but thankfully I'm playing a rogue, and rogues are very high damage classes. And, you know, through my rogue and with my panda, since I have vulnerability and stuff, it ends up working out. But I recommend you guys sit through the fight because it's actually really interesting to watch. So my technique, basically, when it comes down to it, was just kill all of them, leave the one who I figured was weakest, who I determined to be the correlator there. Not the great correlator, obviously that's the boss, but the correlator, the one that's between my two characters right now. I figured he was the weakest because he doesn't really do that much damage. He does a little bit of MP reduction, I think, but the reason I didn't leave that like tree thing is because it does negative resistance on you, which I thought was really annoying. Like, it can give you up to negative 300 resistance or something, and I end up taking more and more damage, and it does like minus 250. So I determined I have to kill that. Thankfully, I was able to tank because my characters have pretty well overmaged vitality gear, and also my mounts give plus 300 vitality, right, since I'm playing with Drago turkeys. So I had enough vitality to sort of tank, because my technique was, as I said, just kill them all, leave one, and basically just wait out the Great Correlator, because he doesn't move that much. He gives himself a spell which gives him AP but removes all his MP, so he doesn't move. But anyways, I decide to sit and tank with my characters. I'm having trouble killing the leafy green thing, because if my panda hits it, then my rogue, like, my panda can't hit it first. My rogue has to hit it first, but my rogue kept getting locked. Fortunately, it worked out, so now I get to kill him. And we're going to progress in the fight here. We're going to progress, sorry. So I pick up the correlator, throw him back, and we're going to continue with our technique here. My panda's pretty low health, only 680. But thankfully, I killed the things that were doing the highest damage and with the negative resistance. So now I was only left with the great correlator and one of the small correlators. Sorry about the creature mode there. I just was having trouble seeing because the creatures are just so big, so I kept getting stuck. So I used my boombot. So I used my boombot to push the great correlator back. And now that you see that correlator only does minus 39. So we're pretty safe here, pretty secure. And plus, I have Silver Dofus, so if anything, if I drop below a certain level, I'll probably gain back like 300 HP or so. So I keep moving my characters back. I decide to have to kill my Attractive Barrel because I'm going to need it later, and I only have one summon in my set. So I'm going to need to resummon it. I know, because I kind of know what I'm going for here. So with my Rogue, I'm just going to keep boosting my bombs. I use Dirty Trick here to set it up. So you see here, he's in line with the opening of the wall, right? So that's perfect. That's exactly what I want, because my goal is going to be to attract him into it and just explode it all. While he's under vulnerability, and with my character's damage and all that, I think it should work out. And I want you guys to stick through to the end, because it's going to be crazy. You'll see the damage, especially when you remember that I am only level 60. Like, this is crazy damage to see at level 60. I'm not going to spoil too much, but just sit through it, and you'll see that it's going to be really cool. So I'm going to actually pick him up, and you'll see here. I'm going to put him down. Now, next turn, we're going to go for it, because now my cooldowns are back in place. I really want to do Last Breath, but I end up being locked and I can't do it. But even without Last Breath, you'll see the damage is going to be pretty cool. So this turn, with my panda, I'm going to do stabilization on myself and come forward. And with my 6 range set, I actually have just enough range to do double vulnerability on the boss. So now you can see here with my rogue, I'm going to try Last Breath. But because it's still level 1, the spell, it doesn't have any like zone. Usually it's like a really big range, but unfortunately I only have like half that range right now since it's level whatever it is. Now we're ready to go. I'm going to pick up the guy. I'm going to put him down. Now the reason I'm putting him down here is because you can see he's also next to the bomb, right? So he will also take bomb wall line damage. So I'm going to make sure to vulnerability him just to make sure that he dies. And now the barrel, really cool. I love this barrel. It's going to attract him. Minus 950. Plus he has some resistance. So I just did minus 1000 just with that one hit. And I'm going to push him, pull him again, minus 1,000. Now each bomb, when I explode it, does minus 1,000. So I could have done way more than the 2k, that which was the HP he had. And you can see here I got full achievements. I got the achievement that tells me that I had done all the achievements for the... that I had done all the achievements for 1 to 50. And that's it for this dungeon. That's it for this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you leave a like. And I'll see you next time. Have a great day and goodbye.